स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू कंटिन्यू विद द लेसन नंबर 6, दैट इज कंपोजिशन ऑफ मैटर. इन दिस लेसन यू हैव स्टडीड अबाउट व्हाट आर द स्टेट्स ऑफ मैटर. देयर आर थ्री स्टेट्स ऑफ मैटर, सॉलिड, लिक्विड एंड गैसेस. ओके, एंड आफ्टर दैट यू हैव स्टडीड अबाउट द एलिमेंट्स. व्हाट आर एलिमेंट्स, व्हाट आर कंपाउंड्स एंड व्हाट आर मिक्सचर्स. दैट डायग्रामेटिकल रिप्रेजेंटेशन इज गिवन ऑन पेज नंबर 41 ऑल्सो. ओके, also you have also watched on video regarding that elements and compounds and mixtures. So today we are going to continue with the lesson, and the first part that we will see will be the types of the elements. Okay, so what are the types of elements? In order to understand elements, let us see this periodic table. Okay, this periodic table is a modern periodic table in which the elements which are present on the earth, in the universe, on the earth, okay, and some of them are discovered in the laboratory. They are written in a particular order, in a particular manner. Okay, so these elements are called, these elements are arranged in the periodic table. So they are the periodic table. This is the periodic table of the elements. Okay, now in this periodic table of the elements, the green colored elements which you can see, they are all non-metals. Okay, boron, carbon, nitrogen, oxygen. Okay, to the right hand side, and to the left hand side you can see the aluminium, gallium. Okay, and other than all this yellow box and purple, these all are the groups. Okay, middle dark blue color, navy blue color elements which are shown. Okay, all these elements are metals, and there are few elements which are between the metals and non-metals. They are called as the metalloids. Okay, which you can see there, arsenic is there. Okay, arsenic one element is there over there between the metals and the non-metals. So earlier only metals and non-metals were discovered, later on the metalloids were discovered there. Now next part will be the types of the compounds. Okay, so what are types of the compound? There are two types of compounds for you, that is organic compounds and inorganic compounds. Inorganic compounds, the compounds which contains carbon, they are called as the organic compounds. We are also organic. Okay, usually we can say that whatever thing is, when it is burned, it converts into black color. It is organic compound. Okay, and inorganic compound which does not contains carbon. Okay, now let us see example. So inorganic, what will be there? DNA, the soap, the paint, the candle. Okay, whatever things are there. And in the inorganic compounds, the salt, diamond, water, then calcium carbonate. Okay, HCl. So this will be inorganic compounds. After that, you have one more point, that is the complex compounds. So complex compounds means what? Now you can see the first diagram shown over here, which is of the human blood, which is hemoglobin. The hemoglobin contains iron. You can see in the middle of the hemoglobin compound there is iron Fe atom. Okay, so like this compound, which consists of the different, which the molecules of the compounds having the complex structure formed by many atoms, and in the center of the structure metal atoms are also included at the center of the structure. Okay, so in hemoglobin iron is there, in plant chlorophyll magnesium is present. Okay, then different examples are there, many examples are there. After that, there is only one sentence about the chemical bond. Okay, so this chemical bond means what? The bond formed by the sharing of the electrons, or the giving of the electrons, or taking of the electron. This, there is a bond formed between them. The dots which are given here, they are the electrons. For example, this is chlorine. Cl means chlorine. Chlorine have 7 electrons in the outermost orbit. So this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 electrons are shown, and one electron is shared by the carbon atom. Middle center, it is given as carbon atom. Okay, so this is the bond form. Next part is homogeneous mixture. In this kind of mixture, you can't distinguish the components, which components are present over there. So this is called as a homogeneous mixture over there. So you can see an example is given: puree, coffee, milkshake, tomato soup. What is heterogeneous mixture? Heterogeneous means what? the components can be classified. Or there are many components over there, like this salad is there, soda ice is there. If you also take ice in the water, that also can be a heterogeneous mixture. Now, talking about the solution, solvent and solute. The diagram is given properly to explain you when you add solute in the solvent, you get a solution. A simple example you can take of the lemon juice. When you add lemon juice to water, your lemon juice is solute, water is solvent, and together they make the solution. Now in this you have many types of mixtures are there, liquid, then solid liquid, then gas and gas, gas liquid, gas solid, which is on the page number 44. After that there is suspension. Where a solid does not dissolve in a liquid, a suspension is formed. A suspension is a mixture in which insoluble particles are suspended in a liquid or the gas. Like the soap, okay? Solid suspension, soap suspension. So in which the water, if you mix the detergent in the water, you can get a soapy or the blurry solution there. This is called as a suspension. And last part is about the colloids. Colloids means, what are the colloids? They are the heterogeneous mixtures, okay? The mixture of the water and the milk, okay? Then the what we can say, it says or if you filter these mixtures, then you cannot separate them, okay? So they are the colloidless. Some examples are foam, then milk, then smoke, then this fog is there, then detergents, paints. And the blood is also a colloid is there. And one experiment you can do to find out if it is a colloidal or no. When you pass a light beam through the water, it pass away. But in the colloidal solution, the light beam is visible.